this time around, we are going a little bit wireless. We're talking about Wi-Fi. Now, you must be wondering, why are we talking about Wi-Fi? Everyone has been doing Wi-Fi for ages. You know, you have Wi-Fi, I have Wi-Fi, all of us have Wi-Fi, but what exactly is Wi-Fi? And has Wi-Fi been the same for the last 20 years, or is it changing? To answer these questions, we have today with us Shantanu Kulkarni. Shantanu is the head of technology software division of STL, and he has been passionate about wireless, 5G, Wi-Fi for a couple of decades. Welcome, Shantanu, and hoping to have a conversation with you about Wi-Fi 6.
Thank you so much, Manish. It's a pleasure to talk to you on this Friday evening. The whole topic is something that I love, so it's going to be a good conversation. Looking forward.
Perfect. So, you know, Shantanu, we have been doing a lot of things on Wi-Fi for quite some time. And the question I have for you is, why should we really care about Wi-Fi these days? You know, we have 4G, I hear 5G is coming. You know, all of this is going to be there and it's going to be fabulous. So why Wi-Fi?
Yeah, Manish, the very fact is that right now, both of us are talking on Wi-Fi. So that's the first thing that we should be taking care about. And I'll tell you, you know what? You breathe, you feel that you breathe in oxygen. I will tell you something. You breathe in somebody's data always. We are always under some kind of data blanket. There is always some numbers flying around us. If you are under four walls or any two walls, you are at home, you are at hotel, you are at mall, you are at airport, you are at television, you are somewhere, right? You will be under the radars of Wi-Fi. Maybe while traveling or commuting for some time, there would be some spots where if you are trekking on some Lohgarh fort or somewhere, you might not have probably. But otherwise, most of the places you will be under the blanket of Wi-Fi.
Really?
And that is a very, very important reason for us to take care. I'll tell you something, you know what? It's a matter of something, I'll tell you, around 12 to 14 months, maybe 16 months, Manish, that Wi-Fi will be having around 51% of all the IP traffic. It will be traveling on Wi-Fi.
More than half of internet's traffic will be on Wi-Fi.
That's very conservatively speaking. And I'm talking about, you know, in a couple of years, we are saying about something like 2023, there will be more than 630 million Wi-Fi spots across the globe. Now imagine, will you find a space where you are not under the Wi-Fi coverage?
Literally one Wi-Fi hotspot for every 10 people in the world.
Exactly. I mean, imagine that. Imagine that.
That's crazy.
I mean, the size and the coverage speed which it is increasing is multifold. Like, you know, like 15, 16, 18% increase in public Wi-Fi that you will be seeing. And the speed at which it goes, which it will give you finally, is four times the speed that you are getting on. So it's going to be very, very exciting times. And it is soon going to be the de facto channel. Or rather, it is already the way we are talking, the way we are in this whole new normal. Wi-Fi will and is already the de facto channel.
Wow, that's interesting. I had no idea that Wi-Fi is dominant, not just one of those things that we have at our home, but this number of Wi-Fi being one for every 10 people out there. That's crazy. I actually, you know, last time when we were just talking outside, I kept hearing you mention Wi-Fi 6. Now, that's actually interesting because, you know, I haven't heard of a number associated with Wi-Fi all the time. You know, it sounds to me like Wi-Fi is getting into a new generation. But what's happening with Wi-Fi? What is this Wi-Fi 6 that we have been started talking about?
You know, these tech people, especially the people who are making standards, they have a habit of making everything very cryptic. I mean, imagine before Wi-Fi 6, the Wi-Fi predecessor, let's call it something as Wi-Fi 5, it was called 802.11ac. I don't know why, at certain point of time, so even though this is called 802.11ax, they came out with calling it much simpler Wi-Fi 6. And then they said that the previous one is Wi-Fi 5, Wi-Fi 4, and so on and so forth.
Okay, so Wi-Fi 6 is a new generation of Wi-Fi. What's special about this generation?
Yes, so it's one that it gives more of what you need. So you need what? You need more data. You mm-hmm. need data faster. You need data when you want. So it does all those things much faster. But, you know, it's not just about data being faster, Manish. It has, the way it has done is what makes a difference. So on one hand, if I tell you that it is four times faster and has four times capacity, if you look, you know, all the promises that all the operators have made about Wi-Fi in the previous times were always more theoretical. So if they say that we will give this Wi-Fi speed, it was always subject to what is the quality of your router in your homes, what is the quality of your mobile device, what is the quality of your laptop, and what is the interference? Does your neighbor have similar Wi-Fi channel? Is he interfering? But what these Wi-Fi 6 guys have done is they have really taken some things from a very different engineering perspective. So goal of them was to have a huge efficiency. Now, while having efficiency, they have really come with a lot of very, very powerful use cases. So I'll tell you, you know, last time, tell me, when did you watch any video, Manish, on Netflix or anywhere which was not HD?
Oh, yeah. Well, I actually think everything is HD now.
Everything's HD.
Yeah. Right? I mean, there are times when you get poor quality reception, but they are trying to send HD.
Right. And I'm sure that in some time you're going to go for this 4K and other stuff, right?
Yeah, it's fabulous. Like, I mean, I've seen it. I've actually seen 8K. It's amazing.
So all this HD quality streaming and AR, VR we are talking about has really gone not just a notch high to a new level with my presence. There's a lot of seamless experience, and we'll talk about it once, you know, we could get into a bit of deeper discussion. How Wi-Fi looks at creating a completely new chapter in user experience. It's not just about having speed or efficiency or something. It's a new user experience. Plus, it talks about one very important thing. The average number of devices, Manish, in your home, I'm sure you have at least 15 devices which are connected. I'm sure that you have, Manish, gone to watch an IPL match or a football match sometime, right?
Yes,
in the stadium,
yes,
live stadium. Have you tried to record a video and try to send it to your friend?
In those environments, honestly, I have not, but I've heard that it's very difficult.
It just chokes up. The congestion is so high, you just cannot do that. And now, not only that, you know, the kind of devices I'm talking about in the household, if there are 50 devices, each competing for that Wi-Fi attention from the router, it's practically impossible to do that with the previous generation of Wi-Fi or the one which we are having currently. So all these things is taken care of by Wi-Fi 6, and hence it becomes something so powerful.
See, what you're saying is that with the quality and the capacity and the experience, the efficiency, the ability to handle dense environments and new devices, and all of this being done securely, this Wi-Fi 6 thing is actually pretty disruptive. I mean, it's not just a little jump from, you know, that 802.11 AC or whatever it was, but it's a massive jump. Would you say it's very disruptive?
Absolutely. It's completely disruptive. I mean, you know, the things that we spoke about, this Wi-Fi does, Manish, is that if you have 5 devices, you have, let's say, a small device which is just connected for, let's say you have a security system, which is just going to say that there is some movement in the house, versus you are watching a 4K video. The kind of attention the router today gives and the kind of channel it gives is similar. But this one comes is with a lot of intelligence. It knows how much attention to give to who's more data hungry, who's less data hungry. One place you are having increased network capacity and high throughput. You're talking about, I didn't speak about battery efficiency, let me speak about that as well. Now what happens is, Wi-Fi 6 comes with a very, very important feature. As you know, you were talking about disruptive is a good word for it. One of the major reasons that any devices actually drain out battery, because they're always trying to connect to a router, or they're trying to get the attention of radio point and access point to get connected. I think it's super disruptive. You know, the kind of impact it's going to have on your home Wi-Fi, your e-learning, your enterprises, your transportation hubs. By the way, public Wi-Fi is going to completely change. When you go to a mall today, the kind of experience you have currently versus what Wi-Fi 6 promises is of a different level. The stadium and venues and all these things is really going to be a big disruptor.
Fundamentally change, right. Okay. It's amazing what you talk about the power management. That will be very useful. I for one, keep hating my phone going out of battery. But you're right. When you think of devices in factories, you don't want them to be charged all the time. That might be its killer app, actually. You did say about how it handles congestion and this next generation of Wi-Fi, it's actually working on so many of these things that it's getting better at. Thanks for sharing this high-level, simplified perspective about Wi-Fi 6 with us, Shantanu. In the next time when we will catch up with you, we'd love to hear from you a little bit more detailed perspective, a little bit more technical, and how this impacts the industry. So looking forward to catching up with you again, Shantanu.
Thank you, Manish. It was a pleasure, and looking forward to the next one.